as a kid. All a nigga wanna have was a Burberry scarf and $3 in my pocket. Instead I got beat with a switch, but I don't give a fuck, but it's on my body. Scars all up on me, but I run around from everybody. Life lesson learned, I better learn from this bitch, nobody. She pushed me around, she didn't give no motherfucks about it. She broke my heart 3 times, but
everybody, what is up? It is JT Sports. I have a special guest on. We have my guy Joe Nubo with the Enough Podcast. Joe Nubo, man, thank you for coming on, man. Welcome.
Yes, sir. Thank you for having me, JT. I'm excited, man. You already know what Sunday is. It's Steelers week. So we know what's going on. We know what's going on.
Yeah. So before we begin, can you tell the people where they can find you at?
Sure thing. Yeah, so if you search up Joe Nubo, you should be able to find my YouTube channel that way. I'm also on Twitter, Instagram, same name. Or if you search up NF Podcast Live, you should be able to find my stuff. I have an audio version of the podcast. I'm also on Sportscaster and, of course, a part of the Fan to Fan Network that we are both on. So, yeah, that's where you can find my stuff. Just search up Joe Nubo. That's N-O-O-B-O.
And make sure that you guys check out the Fan to Fan Network. Me and Joe Nubo are always on there every Sunday breaking down the games. So make sure you guys are able to catch us there. That's going to be linked down in the description down below. So, Joe, man, I brought you on here because I wanted to ask you, what are 5 reasons why the Baltimore Ravens will beat the Pittsburgh Steelers? Now, we already know that you guys have had a couple of issues on the offensive side of the football. You've been heavily critical of the Ravens offense on Twitter. You've received a lot of backlash from your fellow Ravens comrades out there, which is really surprising. So, I mean, what are the couple of things that the Ravens have to do offensively to beat Pittsburgh?
All right. So I would say offensively, man, we just need to do what works. We know what works. The coaching staff knows what works. Greg Roman, especially. A lot of what's been going on with our offense, I feel, is that we're being very experimental. It feels to me like we're being very experimental. And part of that is because, you know, we've seen what happens when we go up against the competition, like in the playoffs and the Chiefs and all that, that our passing game suffers. So I do feel like a lot of what we're doing on offense is we're just trying to work out the kinks in the passing game. We're passing a lot more. We're going to see what Lamar likes to do. We want to see which receivers are able to get open. And it hasn't been working out that well. So, I mean, partly I think is because we're being very experimental. But the thing about this offense is that when we know we need to score, that's when you see Greg Roman start calling read options. That's when you start seeing RPOs. So we know it works, and we just have to do it. So that's really all it is, in my opinion. It's really nothing going on like personnel wise. It's, I mean, obviously we signed Dez Bryant. I'm not really expecting too much out of him, to be honest. We'll see what happens there. But yeah, we just got to do what we do. And, that's really what it's all about on offense there. So
would you agree and say that the first reason why the Ravens will beat the Steelers is because of the fact that the Steelers have been really good against the run, but they haven't faced a running team like Lamar Jackson? I was saying this in my preview. I say, look, as a Steeler fan, it's easy for me to say that, oh, we're going to beat Baltimore because we stopped two of the best running teams in the NFL. We beat Tennessee. Okay, we stopped Derrick Henry from hitting 100 yards. We shut down Cleveland, who still has one of the best rushing attacks. But the difference between Cleveland, Tennessee, and Baltimore is that neither one of those teams have a dual-threat quarterback like Lamar Jackson. And like I was saying, that when you try to stop this Ravens rushing attack, you have to be able to stop Lamar Jackson as well. You're not just game planning to try to stop just these run backs running downhill. You're also game planning to stop Lamar. So would you say the biggest thing that Baltimore has to do is get that run game going? Because, you know, the passing game has been a little bit shaky. The offensive line has gave up 15 sacks throughout 6 games so far, which you guys only allowed 23 sacks in like a complete season last year. So would you say that the run game definitely has to get going? And if you guys can get that, that's one reason why you guys will win this game?
Yeah, I would say that has to be the key. But also, we just can't turn the ball over, plain and simple, because if we make mistakes, you know the Steelers are going to be taking advantage of that. They'll love the short field. Big Ben will take advantage of that. So I would probably say the main key would be not to turn the football over. Just don't make mistakes. Penalties have to be at an all-time low, because last week against the Eagles, we were just undisciplined, bro. Like, it was crazy to watch. It's like penalty after penalty after penalty. Can't do that against the Steelers. So, but as for the running game, listen, I'm not expecting a huge game or a huge day for our running backs for Lamar necessarily, because the Steelers, obviously, probably the best run defense in the NFL right now. So, and Mark Ingram, as far as I know, little banged up. He's expected to come back, but he hasn't really been contributing that much this season. I think that probably he's still a little bit shaken up from last year, I would imagine. Gus, if we can get him going, that would be great. You know, he's that north-south power running back. And J.K. Dobbins has come in every now and again. He's really fast. He's really has everything that it takes to be like a three-down back for us. But the coaching staff is just very much into not giving opportunities to the rookies early on. Yeah, I would say if we can get the running game going, it's not going to be good for the Steelers. They should be playing to stop the run still, even though it hasn't been as potent as it was last year. I would definitely still say to be concerned about the running game, be concerned for the read options and RPOs and all that for sure.
So I think that's like two or three reasons. So two more reasons. Let's focus more on the defense side of the football. So we know that Baltimore, their defense is just as good, if not better, than Pittsburgh's. I think they're pretty much evenly matched, but I would go on a limb and say that Baltimore's defense is just a tad bit better than Pittsburgh's, because Pittsburgh is going to be missing Devin Bush, and you guys are pretty much fully healthy. So if Devin Bush is playing, then I think you guys be evenly matched. And these defensive lines are pretty good too, especially with the addition of Yannick Ngakoue. And when you look at the Steelers offense, okay, we know with the Steelers that they are really good on third down. So for Baltimore to win this game, other than getting off the field on third down, because I feel like that's too cliche to say, what are two other reasons that the Baltimore Ravens defense will be able to win this game for them and be able to stop the Steelers offense?
Yeah, so something to look out for. While the Ravens defense is pretty much fully healthy, we are dealing a little bit with some cornerback injuries, some CB injuries there. Anthony Averett, who's like our fourth stringer, he's going to be out for 6 weeks. Tavon Young, our starting nickel slot corner, he's out for the season. So obviously we still have guys like Marlon Humphrey, Marcus Peters, and Jimmy Smith. So I'm obviously not too concerned about that. But if the Steelers go like five wide, which I'm assuming they will, spread offense, that could potentially be trouble. And sorry if you hear in the background, people are mowing their lawns right now. They just decide to mow their lawns every time I stream. I would definitely say to look out for that. One thing I want to see from this defense is to get Ben uncomfortable, because quite frankly, I don't think Ben has been that uncomfortable this season. He's only been sacked, I believe, 8 times, right? And what the Steelers want to do right now, they want to hit you with that quick strike, right? That one read, dump it off immediately, get rid of the ball, get it in the receiver's hands, right? We cannot allow Ben to do that, because if you just allow him to just make pre-snap reads, diagnose everything that's going on, and then just get rid of the ball that quick, it's not going to be a pretty day for the Ravens defense. We need to make him uncomfortable. We need to be getting in his face. We need to be, you know, clogging up passing lanes. And that's pretty much it. I mean, you know, aside from that, the thing that I know a lot of people are going to look back to the Chiefs game where Patrick Mahomes absolutely just tore us up. But the reason he was tearing us up is because he's able to roll out of the pocket, extend those plays, which Ben has some of that, but it's definitely not to the level that Mahomes has. So yeah, that's probably what I would be looking out for sure.
Yeah, man. I would like to add one more thing. So the thing with Ben Roethlisberger, that if you are a Ravens fan, if you're able to clog up those pass lanes and you're able to play tight, you know, coverage, like maybe you can play some tight zone coverage on some tight man-to-man coverage and force Big Ben to, you know, just go ahead and thread the needle, because Big Ben still has that gunslinger mentality. Now, although this is pretty much his most efficient season that he's ever played in his entire career in terms of taking care of the football, like we saw last week against Tennessee when he tried to force that pass to Juju Smith-Schuster with like nearly the whole entire Tennessee Titans defense there, he will force passes, you know, every once in a while. So if you're Baltimore and you're a Ravens fan and you're able to play some tight man-to-man coverage and force Big Ben to, you know, kind of have to thread the needle into some tight spaces, I think you have to be feeling really good about your chances, man. So Joe Nubo, man, longtime friend of mine on YouTube, known him for going on about 2 years now. I'm glad to have you on, man. Once again, let the people know they can find you before we let you go, man. And we appreciate you from coming on.
Of course, JT. Thanks for having me, man. Of course, I'm always willing to be a part of your channel, man. No doubt. So once again, Joe Nubo. You can search me up on YouTube, probably on Google as well. You can find my Twitter, Instagram, all that good stuff. Audio version of the podcast, NF Podcast Live. It is mostly Ravens, but I welcome every fan of every team. You're welcome there to watch, to listen. And yeah, that's pretty much it, man. But I'm excited, obviously. And we just got to go out there and be the better team. That's really what it's all about. It's going to be an AFC North battle.
All right, man. We appreciate you coming on, man. Take care.